What's up, everybody? Today, we're going to be taking a look at the Stug IV, the newest vehicle to come to Battlefield 5 and all its quirks and features, so stay tuned. So, like I said, guys, today we're going to be taking a look at the Stug IV. This is the first vehicle we have gotten from our Tides of War events, and it's kind of an interesting one. So, let's go ahead and take a look at the unlock requirements. Now, this is probably one of the harder things to have unlocked through all of Tides of War, so it is a little bit of a hassle. Let's start off with the first thing. Earn 1,000 score while in a mobile ground unit. The top path has you repair half-tracks piloted by squad mates. This is a kind of a theme for the top path. It's a lot of squad-based play. They want you to play as a team, and that's what you're going to have to do. So if you don't have a good squad, this top path might not be for you. You may have to go through kind of the harder challenges down below. Speaking of which, those down below challenges, the first one is going to be kill or assist in killing 10 enemies while in a tank or half track. Then we go on to the next level of challenges. The middle path is deal 1,000 damage to enemy vehicles or destroy 3 vehicles while in a tank or half track. That gets you on to the road trip challenge. That's earn 300 score while in a reinforcement vehicle. This one is relatively easy. All you kind of have to do is get a half track and capture a point in conquest. That gives you about 300 points. So you don't even have to worry about killing anyone. You just need to be able to call in that reinforced vehicle. Now, to finish off this path, the last thing is you have to capture an objective while in a tank or a half track. Once again, relatively easy to do in this bottom path. The only real challenge in this one is to deal 1,000 damage to enemy vehicles, but that can be done through regular play or kill or assist in killing 10 enemies while in a tank or half track. Let's go ahead along that top path. This one is a little bit easier once you get through the squad repairs. The first thing is to build 5 tank traps, vehicle resupply stations, or cannons. You're gonna need the support for that one. The next one is prepared positions. You deal 100 damage to tanks or half tracks in one life using an infantry gadget or stationary weapons. This one was a little bit more difficult. I ended up using it, getting it through assault, though one of the easier ways would probably just be to plant a couple mines around the map and hope that you take out a tank or one of the light vehicles, because you just need to do damage to ground vehicles. The last thing on this path is to spot 5 enemy tanks. This is relatively easily done. Grab that spotting scope with the recon and just head on in. The spots reset after about 15 seconds on tanks. So if you're far away, you can easily just keep respotting the same tank over and over again and get your five spots in under a couple minutes. Now, the final challenge to unlock the Stug is going to be to kill 20 enemies while attacking enemy objectives using a mobile ground vehicle. This is probably one of the hardest ones and one of the more annoying ones because of the modifier that you have to do this while attacking. What this means is that either A, the people that you are killing have to be in an enemy-controlled area, or you yourself have to be within the bounds of an enemy-controlled area killing someone else. This makes it kind of hard, but it can definitely be done. The hardest thing with this, with all the people trying to get through this challenge, is actually finding yourself a vehicle to use to get through this challenge. So, after you go through all of that hassle, what do you get? Well, you get a slightly different Panzer IV in the terms of the Stug. So, let's go ahead and head through some quirks and features. As the driver, your primary gun carries 24 rounds, and you better get used to those 24 rounds, because you have no coaxial machine gun. You do, though, have a fire rate of about 20 rounds per minute. Also, you do have a faster reverse than any other armored vehicle. That lets you escape and disengage from enemies relatively quickly, pull back from ridges, do that sort of thing, kind of ambush in the style that the Stug would want. Left on the D-pad is going to give you emergency repair, while right is going to disperse smoke. You can have 2 other crew members in the tank with you. One is the standard rooftop machine gunner, and the next one is probably one of the more interesting things. It's a periscoped MG34 that has 360 degrees of coverage and a small zoom. This is more interesting because it helps protect you from infantry, and it makes it so that one of your crew members isn't vulnerable when they're trying to defend you against infantry, unlike the regular rooftop machine gunner. Additionally, this periscoped machine gun is kind of interesting as it has no ammo limit, like the traditional coaxial machine gun that's controlled by the drivers. so you can kind of stand off and you don't have to really worry about them running out of ammo at any point. As a base vehicle, you're going to want to go through the specializations. The base cannon just will not stand up to other vehicles, so you will find yourself being outclassed a bunch of the time with that default cannon. So let's go ahead and take a look at the specializations. For the first part, you can either choose between a reinforced engine or a smoke launcher. For tier 2, you can choose Zimmerit. The middle track is going to be track skirts, and the right-hand track is going to be field repair. For level 3, you have either an improved loading mechanism or the PAC-40, aka the 75mm, the upgraded gun. And the final path is going to be between case ammo, S-mine launchers, or an AP round. Personally, I went for the upgrade of the engine and side skirts. Because there's no turret, these are the two upgrades that you can do that'll make it harder for your vehicle to become disabled, that grants you additional survivability, that helps you live a lot longer, and it helps you kind of live another day to fight the fight. Now, the other reason I didn't go for that is on the right-hand path, you have smoke launcher and field repair, and you kind of have versions of that already by default with the Stug. You have a smoke screen, so you don't really need the smoke launcher. And the field repair, while the insta-fix on a disabled part would be nice and is nice, I would much rather just reinforce it and not have to worry about it being disabled in the first place, and then also having that reserve heal of the emergency repair in my back pocket. So those are the first two I went. The next thing, I went with the PAC-40, and that's because the 10% faster reload would be nice. The fact is that the default cannon fails to put out damage that can be dangerous to each other armor, so you're kind of useless unless you have the PAC-40. You can definitely get by with the default cannon, but it's not something I would really recommend. Now, the last upgrade is kind of a toss-up, and it really depends on your playstyle. The S-mines can be really nice as an early warning system to help you warn up against like sneaking infantry in case you get like really focused in on one area, while the AP rounds give you the ability to deal with more armor. Not only is your primary weapon effective against armor, but this also gives you additional rounds to put down range. So that being said, how does the Stug perform? Well, not so well, unfortunately. The advantages of the Stug, there aren't many. Its lower profile does make it slightly harder to hit, but not by much. Beyond that, everything else about the Stug is kind of middling, if not in the struggle. The lack of a turret means that you need to be constantly aware of your surroundings and how the battle is flowing. You can be easily flanked, and if you are, it can spell the end for you, especially if it's other armor. And that's because it shares the same upgraded gun as like the Panzer IV, so it has a similar damage profile to the upgraded medium tanks. This means that many blows between the upgraded medium tanks kind of just trade out, so it really depends on who's going to get the first hit, or if someone gets a lucky bounce off their shell. And as far as taking out heavy tanks, well, good luck. If you don't hit them multiple times before they see you, you're kind of out of luck. Because of the recent armor patch to the heavy tanks, the Stug struggles to kill the Churchill as far as a heavy tank goes, or the Crocodile tank, just because it has so much more armor. They are able to eat a lot more tank shells than you are able to dish out. Overall, I'm glad I unlocked the Stug, but it's not something I think I'd be leaving in my armory or in my company. It's something neat, and hopefully DICE will decide to upgrade it in the future to give it a more of a tank killer role, which would be nice. The fact that in order to play it, you kind of have to stay a little bit further back because you don't have that swivel does put this at an inherent disadvantage, and it's definitely something cool to see in the game. I look forward to seeing how they change this, hopefully in the future, to give it a buff to make it more competitive against other armor in the game. So what do you guys think? Do you guys like the Stug? Let me know down below. If you like this video, go ahead, hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, do all of that fun stuff down below. Guys, my name is TommyBoy601. I hope you have a great rest of your day.